The African-American community in Watts had been scarred by riots in the mid-1960s, leaving 34 dead. In August 1972, Stax organized a benefit festival of peace and music in Los Angeles. It drew more than 100,000 people, a fifth of the city's black population.
Soul music sort of rose to its zenith in terms of what it could do politically, economically, and culturally all at once. And that was at Watts Stax.
I'm the son of a bitch!
I ended up going to Watts when it was still smoking from riots and urban frustration, neglect. We were into that kind of setting with that kind of audacity and that kind of ambition.
Went to rent the stadium. They kind of laughed at us. You're some little record company from out of Memphis, Tennessee. And who do you say these artists are? What's the names?
Respect yourself. Yeah, you oughta respect yourself.
If you're walking around thinking that the world
had been riots where they burned down just about everything, you know. And Watts Stax brought all these 100,000 people together. That was the largest crowd any of us had ever seen.
This was trying to give something back to the neighborhood. Only cost it a dollar.
Can you write on to? I'm gonna tell you what you gotta do. Drop your wings, feet start kicking. Now you know you're doing the fucking chicken. Oh, oh.
We're still now on this curve of trying to carry forth the resurrection and the ascension. And that caused others to realize that they could do the same thing in their various ghetto communities across America.
That is why I challenge you now to stand together, raise your fists together, and engage in our national black litany. Do it with courage and determination. I am somebody. I am somebody. I may be poor, but I am somebody. I may be on welfare, but I am somebody. I may be unskilled. But I am.
I am
somebody.
There were many messages, even mixed messages, running through that very moment that Al and I had our fists extended. We'd survive the rubbish. Like a sphinx rising from the ashes, we'd come back to life again, and there we were at this awesome moment in history.
The brothers all of us have been waiting for, brother Isaac.
I had preached that our music was a reflection of what goes on in our lives and our lifestyles. And Larry Shaw said, well, then what we need to do is film this and make it real.